All right, friends, here we are for yet another analytical review of these Jack-specific figures based on the Japanese characters from the technology company known as Nintendo. All right, so where to start with the new ones? Well, I think we'll go front and center with the man himself, Mario. So this is the new figure that I just picked up at Walmart. You can see it's Mario in a marching position with his hat off of his head. The reason why I put these two here, because... Well, this is the Super Mario Odyssey one where he's also not wearing a hat. He's got Cappy, he can spin on his finger. And this is the Running Mario one, which they've done many variations of Running Mario. The reason why I pulled out these two is just to show you the difference between these and this new figure. As you can see, he's marching, not running. And he's also a more of a regular Mario, not Mario Odyssey. There's no texture in his hair, no texture on his overalls. So that is this figure. Now, I'm putting so much emphasis on these differences, just so you know when you see this at Walmart or wherever, that you don't get confused and think you already have this one. For you collectors, just in case, because I get confused all the time. There's so many different Marios. Sometimes I forget which ones I have and which ones I don't. So here he is, out of the box, very nice sculpt. There's no articulation in his legs or anything. His arm that holds the hat can move. Actually, both arms can move. And of course, this is based off of artwork of Mario doing this, holding his hat and marching like this. And there's also a Luigi artwork to accompany it. So hopefully they'll do a Luigi figure like this soon. Now the hole is down inside his leg behind his knee where you put the stand so that he can... Oh, the stand actually fits in him quite well, unlike certain other Mario figures of this collection. Now here's the hat. He's got a little nub on the end of the hat, probably for him to hold on to. Can he actually wear the hat is my question. Not really, I guess. that's as good as it gets. Now as far as holding the hat, he holds it on the little nub there. You kind of just set it there in his hand and you set him up nicely. Here I go! Alright, so that is Mario. It does not seem to stay in his hand very well. Alright, that's much better. See, I had to just really jam the hat in there to get it to stay in his hand. So there we go. That is the newest Mario figure. And also as part of that set, these are the ones. So we got a repeat of Ice Mario and Luigi, and then we got Blue Toad and Yoshi, who I guess we should unbox those ones next. We'll start with Blue Toad. So here are the previous Toad figures that we've done. The regular Toad, the Green Toad, and of course Cat Toad. And so this new Blue Toad can now join them. It's just a repaint of the regular figure. I don't know, have they done other Toads like this? I'm trying to remember. I don't think, these are the only three I have of regular Toads. Green, Blue, and regular Toad. I don't know if they did yellow. I don't think they did purple. I think there's a... No, they haven't done an action figure either. I want to say there's more Toads, but I can't remember. I really can't. I might be confusing them with Kinects. I know Kinects, they did Fire Toad. I know they did Green Toad there and Yellow Toad. Yeah, I think I'm thinking of the Kinects. But as far as Jack Specific, I believe these are the only three Toads. Well, four Toads if you count the Cat Toad. So there we go. There's a new Toad to add to the collection. How many times can I say Toad in this video? Alright, we're actually going to save Yoshi for later, because right now we want to talk about the villains. Here we go. So we got, previously, they have of course made Bowser Jr. and Larry Koopa. The reason why I'm pointing out those two specifically, because they are the young generals in the Koopa army. And now the new one is this, Iggy Koopa. How fantastic is he looking? And also, in this same set is Magic Koopa. So this is super cool. This is our first time getting this size figure of Iggy, and this is our first time getting anything from Jack Specific of Magic Koopa. So that is way exciting. And then also in this set is just repeats of Boo, Mario, and the Odyssey Mario. So let's get these guys open. So here is the Iggy figure. He has the wand that is a removable accessory, of course. He actually has twisting wrists, right? His head does not move though. His arms do move, his legs do not, but he comes with a clear removable stand that helps him stay up, which is good because he is leaning over. This is based on his artwork from New Super Mario Brothers Wii. So there we go. We now have two Koopalings in this scale, Larry and Iggy. And I know the bigger ones, the like 5-inch scale, I think they're planning to do Ludwig and another one, I believe. Hopefully we get all 7 Koopalings in both sizes. That would be fantastic. But right now, we got these two, and who knows, maybe they'll just end up bringing out a 7-pack of them someday, like the pack that we're going to be opening later of Yoshi's. But let's get Magic Koopa. So here he is, the fan favorite Magic Koopa, or comic, whichever you want to believe he is. Magic Koopa is the species, because there are many of him. However, comic is Bowser's like right-hand man, his royal wizard, right? And so look, he's even got feet under his robe. So that is pretty cool. He's got moving arms. He has his wand, of course. His wrists twist. I mean, they are really doing great things with this line of figures now. I'm kind of happy they're more focusing on just Mario than all of Nintendo, because I feel like they can focus in on these cool characters that we wouldn't have gotten otherwise, because they're a bit more obscure in the Mario universe. So there we go. Isn't that cool? They all got their magic wands there. And those are our new villains. Super awesome. So far, let's see. We've unboxed Magic Koopa and Iggy. We got the Blue Toad. We got the Marching Mario. And now, for the last part, the Yoshis. Mario, we can't even see Yoshi because you're holding your hat there, silly. So as far as normal Yoshis, I think I've collected all the ones that they've released. I know there's a yellow baby Yoshi that I was never able to find, but I have the blue baby Yoshi. So we have green, red, black, dark blue, yellow, and orange Yoshis. Yeah. Again, I believe that's all that they have released. Now, we have this new one, which is a green Yoshi again, but he's in a running position. So that is very cool. You know, they've done Mario in a couple different positions. They've done Luigi in at least two. And now we're starting to get different Yoshis too. So we have them all running together. They're all in running positions. So Yoshi came with a clear stand to keep him up. One thing I didn't mention with Iggy is that he has a very specific shape in his foot. So you can put the stand on right and it stays inside him really well. And that, of course, is like Yoshi also. Both Yoshi and Iggy are really good with their clear stands. It helps them stay up really well, whereas previous figures, such as these Marios, their stands just kind of fall right out and it's hard to get them to balance right. So that is pretty cool about this Yoshi. So let's go ahead, we'll put this new Yoshi right up here, because he's a variant, just like that Yoshi. But as for the main Yoshis, I finally got the GameStop pack. So this is a pack of 5 Yoshis. You can get this for $22 at GameStop. And it comes with the traditional green Yoshi, the new light blue Yoshi, the white Yoshi, who's also new, and then you get repeats of yellow Yoshi and black Yoshi. So that'll bring our unique Yoshi count up to 8, I believe. Did they do a pink Yoshi? I know they did a 5-inch figure of pink Yoshi, but I don't recall ever finding a 3-inch Yoshi like these. Let me know in the comments if you recall them making a pink Yoshi, or if you own a pink Yoshi of this set. Really quickly, in this Yoshi set, I just want to show off the back of the box. I thought those are some cool pictures of the figures themselves. And the Yoshi set comes with a cool background of the Mushroom Kingdom. It's awfully short though, so can't do a whole ton with it. Although, I don't know, maybe, because my background could probably use some work. I could probably put it back there somehow. That could be cool. And the figures themselves. All right, so as I mentioned before, we have these 3 repeat Yoshis, but we also have this brand new light blue Yoshi. At least it's brand new to me. There is a chance they have released him previously, and this is a re-release. And then the white Yoshi. I believe I'm like 99% sure this is the only way to get a white Yoshi that's a brand new release. So yeah, there we go. There's the 8 colored Yoshis. And yeah, like I said, you get 3 repeats. But if you ever want to reenact the Yoshi Stampede from Smash Brothers, you're going to need as many Yoshis as you can get. So that's why it's good to have extras. So there we go. Do we have all the colors from Mario Kart? I know there's 8 colors in Mario Kart, but I think there's pink. Which one of these is not in Mario Kart? Huh, I don't remember. Anyway, so friends, that is all for the new world. Sorry, these are not World Nintendo. These are the new Super Mario set of figurines from Jack's Pacific. Let me know if there's any other new ones that I have to go searching for, because the more the merrier. Maybe we should do a collection video of just this set sometime. You know, just the 3-inch Jack's Pacific, you know, figures, Nintendo figures, because there are so many cool ones out there, and they just keep making more and more and more. Look for them at GameStop, look for them at Walmart, or anywhere else that they might sell these toys. So friends, let me know what you think in the comment section below, and have a wonderful holiday. Toast!